अस्सलामु अलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास 12। सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू आवर टॉपिक दैट वॉज चैप्टर नंबर 8 इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स। इन इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स वी हैड स्टडीड रिगार्डिंग इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी ड्यू टू यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज स्फेरिकल शेल और होलोस्फीयर एंड वी हैड derived and derivation for the same that was the E is equal to rho r square upon epsilon naught r square. Number 2, electric field intensity due to an infinitely long straight charged wire, and the formula for the same was E is equal to lambda upon 2 pi epsilon naught r square. And number 3, we had electric field due to a charge infinite plane sheet, that was E is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. Now all these three are applications of Gauss's law that we had already studied. After this, I had explained you regarding electric potential and potential energy. In that, we had seen an expression for expression for potential energy, and we had derived in formula for the same was nothing but V is the potential difference, but here we had we were deriving an expression for the potential energy, that is nothing but U. It is an energy, so we had to write U, that is UR is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon R. So this was the expression that we had already derived in our previous video lecture. So let's move further. In the continuation of the same subtopic, see, this is nothing but the equation number 1 that we had already labeled it. Now, we have to go according to that only. Now, let's see the concept of the potential. But before this, we had already seen some units of potential energy, that was nothing but, as this is nothing but the energy. So, the SI unit of this will be nothing but joule. And we had seen that the 1 joule is the energy stored in a moving charge of 1 coulomb through a potential difference of 1 volt. That's mean how you are going to define the 1 joule. So you are going to define the 1 joule as is the energy stored in moving charge of 1 coulomb through a potential difference of 1 volt. Then another convenient unit of energy was nothing but electron volt, that is denoted by small e and capital V. So small e and capital V, it is nothing but the unit of potential energy, which is electron volt, which is the charge in the kinetic energy of an electron while crossing 2 points maintained at a potential difference of 1 volt. So how you are going to define the electron volt? So is the change in the kinetic energy of an electron while crossing 2 points maintained at a potential difference of 1 volt. So this was all regarding the potential energy. Now let's see the concept of potential. So the concept of potential, so we were having equation number 1 with us. So equation 1 gives the potential energy of 2 particle system at a distance r from each other. See, now UR is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon R. See, there is a printing mistake in your textbook. There is an extra R is given. So in denominator, see, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R. This R will not be there. Okay? Or what you can do, any one of the R in the denominator you should cancel, because it is a printing mistake. So what you have to do it here, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught r will be same, but q1 q2 upon r, this r should be cancelled. There is only q1 q2. Fine. Now what, see the next step, what we have, what is here, see, instead of 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, what is written here? Q1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught r, and Q2, just let's take it out from the bracket. Or what you can do, you can take out Q1 as out of the bracket and Q2 in the bracket. So this all the last two equation is nothing but the same, just what we had rearranged the term. Okay, so why we are doing this? See, the quantity in any one of the bracket, the quantity in the bracket only. Okay, so this quantity, which quantity? The quantity Vr is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught r depends upon the charge Q and location of a point at a distance small r from it. So this is defined as the electrostatic potential of the charge Q at a distance r from it. Okay, so what is the concept of potential difference? So now you will able to understand what is the concept of the potential difference. So the quantity in the bracket, this is defined as the electrostatic potential of the charge Q at a distance r from it. In terms of potential, we can write the potential energy of two charges system as UR is equal to V1R Q2 is equal to V2R Q1. Are the respective potentials of charge Q1 and Q2 at distance r from either. Okay, so therefore electrostatic potential energy, that is U, is equal to electric potential into charge. Okay, so finally what we are having, electrostatic potential energy, that is U, is equal to electric potential, that is V, into charge Q. So we can say that, or U is equal to V into Q. Okay, U is equal to V into Q. Or what we can do, if we have to find only the electric potential, that is V. So what we are having, electrostatic potential, that is V, is equal to electric potential energy per unit charge. Okay, see, U is equal to V into Q. If we have to find only V, so what we will have, V is equal to U upon Q, because Q in the right hand side, it is in the multiplication form. We have to find only V. So what we will do now, we will take the Q to the left hand side, so it will become in the denominator, or left or right, whatever you can do. So just rearrange the term. I'm going to take the V into the left hand side and other term at the right hand side. So I will have only V is equal to U upon Q. That is, electric potential difference between any two points in an electric field can be written as V2 minus V1 is equal to U2 minus U1 upon Q. See, it is in potential difference. That means we have to subtract something. Difference, okay, as it is the potential difference. Potential means what? V. So if you are having a two value of the potential, that is V1 and V2, and we have to find the difference between them, that is the potential difference. So what we basically write final value minus initial value. So what is our final value? That is V2, and initial value is nothing but the V1. So how we can define the potential difference? So potential difference will be nothing but V2 minus V1 is equal to U2 minus U1 upon Q2. Sorry, Q. Okay. Now, why we had written here U2 minus U1? Because potential difference in energy, the energy for the first potential difference and the energy for the second, it will be like this. So V2 minus V1 is equal to U2 minus U1 upon Q. So basically change in energy, it is nothing but work done, change in work done also. So it, we can write this as a dW upon Q, that is work done. dW is nothing but the work done or change in
potential energy per unit charge to move the charge from point 2 to 1. Okay, that means we are having two point number 1 and point number 2, and what we have to do, we have to move the charge. So charge is moving from point 1 to point 2. So energy is also going to change. At point 1, energy is nothing but U1 of the charge, and at point 2, energy is nothing but the U2 of the charge. Similarly, the potential difference at point 1 of the Q is nothing but V1, and the potential difference of the charge Q at point 2 is nothing but the V2. So all this thing is nothing but dW upon Q, that is work done per unit charge to move the charge from point 2 to point 1. So this is actually electric potential difference between two point charge in an electric field. Okay, now let's see, we had studied electric field and electric potential. Now let's see the relation between electric field and electric potential. So here we have to consider the electric field produced by a charge plus Q, as you can see in the diagram, kept at a point O. Let us calculate the work done to move a unit positive charge from point M to point N. As you can see, this small displacement is here, M to N. So we have to calculate the work done to move a unit positive charge from point M to N, which is at a small distance of dx from M. The direction of the electric field at M is along OM. You can see E. So the direction of this is nothing but along OM, vector of OM. Thus the force acting on the unit positive charge is along OM. So the work done. Now basically, what is the basic formula of the work done? Work done is nothing but force into displacement. So force, so dW is nothing but the work done. Now basically work done is nothing but W only, but here is what, the small displacement is there. That's when the work done should also be small. That's why it is dW here. So dW is equal to minus of F dot dx. Now what is F? It is force. And what is dx? It is the small displacement. Now what is, why there is a negative sign? See, if you observe here, the direction of the electric field is along OM. That's mean if you take your left hand, that's mean from left to right according to the diagram. But if you observe, charge is moving from M to N, that's mean from right to left. So force is nothing but opposite of that. The work done is nothing but performing opposite to that. Yes, so that's why negative sign is there. So negative sign indicate that we are moving the charge against the force acting on it. Now dW is equal to minus of F dot dx, and we also know that dW, W and E. So instead of that, what we can else write? Minus of E dot dx, energy, work done and energy. Okay, so as we had already seen that the work done is nothing but equivalent to change in potential. Yes, so in that we can write the positive work done on a unit positive charge, that is dW, it's equal to dV, that is difference in potential between M to N. So instead of dW, we can write that the dW and dV is equal. So instead of that dW, we can able to write the dV. So finally, we can say that dV is equal to minus of E dot dx. Now, how we can say that, how we can define electric field E? Now E is nothing but minus of dV upon dx, because we have to derive an expression for electric field. Now see, we had already derived an expression for electric potential. Now let's see the, what is the relation between electric field and electric potential. So this is the relation between electric field and electric potential, that is electric field is equal to minus of dW, dV upon dx. Thus, the electric field at point in an electric field is the negative of the potential gradient at that point. Now, dx is the length, potential difference per unit length. There is a one more term. If we are having potential difference per unit length, so the potential difference per unit length is defined as potential, is called as potential gradient. So how we can describe the relation between electric field and potential difference? That the electric field at a point in an electric field is the negative of potential gradient at that point. So this is all about the relation between electric field and electric potential. Now let's continue this subtopic. So in this subtopic we are having one more term, that is zero potential. So the nature of the potential is such that its zero point is arbitrary. This does not mean that the choice of zero point is insignificant. Once the zero point of the potential is set, then every potential is measured with respect to that reference. The zero potential is set conveniently. In case of potential, in case of a point charge or localized collection of charges, the zero point is set at infinity. For electrical circuit, the earth is usually taken to be at zero potential. Thus, the zero potential at point A in an electric field is the amount of work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to point A. So how you can define the zero potential? The zero potential at point A. Now observe the diagram. So the zero potential at point A in an electric field is the amount of work done. What you have to keep remember is the amount of work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to point A. From infinity to the present location. So here present location is having point A. So the work done, performed to bring the charge, to brought any charge from infinity to their present location, this is called as zero potential. And usually earth is, for electrical circuit, the earth is usually taken to be at zero potential. So this is all about the zero potential. This is all about the potential energy, potential difference and electric field and zero potential. So let's stop here.